Okay, hello everybody, it's Lou. We're going to try another older song. This one is the Beatles, and I tried to pick out a beginner version of the song. This one is Yesterday. And we're going to do something different again. We are going to put the chord lesson towards the end of the video. And the reason I say towards the end of the video, after the chord lesson, I'm going to go over tabs with you and show you also how to pick the song if you decide you want to learn that. And the reason I'm saving it for the end of the video is some of you guys may not want to try it. I would suggest trying it though, because it is kind of a good thing to learn if you know, like I'm trying to do right now, is learn how to tab and pick out some songs. And I will try to show you how to read tabs in case you don't know. So the chords we're going to learn today, G, B7, E minor, C, B7, and A7. And I will show you the B7 chord right now. That's going to be first fret, index finger, 4th string, 2nd fret, middle finger, 5th string, 2nd fret, ring finger, 3rd string, and 2nd fret, 1st string with the pinky. That's your B7. And the other chords you probably already know, but if not, I'm going to do the lesson again towards the end of the video, after the end of this part of the video. Okay, so the intro is really just a G chord, and you're going to strum 2 measures of 8. So you would just bass, and it's only from the 4th string down, so it'd be, okay, and then one more time, okay, and verse 1, we're going to do G, B7, E minor, C, D7, G, E minor, A7, C, and G, okay, and that's going to be, and I don't sing, so bear with me, Yesterday, the B7. All my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Okay, I have to scroll down. Oh, I believe and yesterday. Okay. Verse 2, same chords, G, B7, E minor, C, D7, G, E minor, A7, C, and G. So suddenly, I'm not half the man I used to be. Scrolling down again. There's a shadow hanging over me. Oh, yesterday came suddenly. And then we're going to go into the bridge, and that's a B7, E minor, D7, and G twice. And that would be why she had to go. I don't know. She wouldn't say. Okay, second half of that is I said something wrong. Long for yesterday. Okay, then you've got the last verse and then the coda. And just so you know, the last G actually also goes into the coda. So that's going to be yesterday. It was such an easy game to play. Now I need a place. Hideaway. Gotta scroll down. Oh, I believe. And yes, today. Okay, and the coda is. Okay, so in other words, the last G is the same G you're playing in the coda. And now those chords are A7, C, and G. And the beginning of it is the last G on the word yesterday. Okay, so let's go over the chords that we just did. And that's pretty much the song. I already showed you the B7, so we'll show it to you one more time. First fret, 4th string, index finger, 2nd fret, 5th string, middle finger, 2nd fret, 3rd string, ring finger, and 2nd fret, 1st string with the pinky. Okay, our G chord is 2nd fret 5th string, index finger, 3rd fret 6th string middle finger, and 3rd fret 1st string with the ring finger. E minor, I think I'm doing it this way, 2nd fret 5th string middle finger, and 2nd fret 4th string with the ring finger. And of course, by now you know you can also do it with those two fingers. C chord, 1st fret 2nd string index finger, 2nd fret 4th string middle finger, and 3rd fret 5th string with the ring finger. Okay, D7, 1st fret 2nd string index finger, 2nd fret 3rd string middle finger, and 2nd fret 1st string with the ring finger. Okay, and then you got an A7, 2nd fret 4th string index finger, and 2nd fret 2nd string with the ring finger. Okay, now here comes the hard part. I'm going to try to, because I can't put the annotations up until the video is over. So I really can't do anything but try to pretend that I can see on this video right now what I'm trying to tell you. So let's start from here. When you're looking at tabs, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lines in front of you with numbers on them, which basically... The problem with tabs that makes it a little harder for some people is that where we're looking at the guitar, you're looking at 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 as a string, starting from the top, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. But when you're looking at the tabs, you're looking at strings from the bottom. Let me see if I can get you over here though. Okay, and you have the sun glare that I have coming in my window. So basically what I'm saying, let's say that this is the tabs, and there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lines. Well, the way they're counted is, okay, now I'm not talking about a guitar, I'm talking about you're looking at tabs right now. So forget this is the neck of a guitar, and just pretend like this is a measure of tab music, okay? Which would be extended from about here to here, okay? From about here to here. Okay, so you're looking at that now. So when you're looking at it, this is actually the first string on it. That's the second string, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th. Okay, so when you're looking at tabs, it's just the opposite. For instance, on a guitar, it's 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. When you're looking at tabs, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which would be strings. And again, I got this off the internet, so if I'm saying a string name wrong, don't blame me. E, B, G, D, A, E. That would be basically, again, if you're looking at tabs, not the guitar, it would be E, B, G, D, A, E for the strings, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so now we're looking at a guitar and we're looking at tabs, and it's saying, and it has a 3 on the very top of the tabs. That's telling you, if you're looking at a guitar, that's the first string, which is here, and the 3 means 3rd fret. So assuming this was a 3rd fret, that would mean to take your finger and you're going to play the first string, 3rd fret. Now remember, on tabs, it's going to be, the 3 is going to be on the top when you're looking at it. It's going to be up here, but it's in reverse. Hope that makes sense. So you're on the 3rd fret, even though I'm not on the 3rd fret, let's assume I am. And the 3 means 3rd fret, 1st string. And then in this instance, we have, right on top of it, we have a 0, and on top of that another 0, and on top of that another 0. So that would mean, because it's going to be, on the, again, looking at tabs, it's going to be 3, 0, 0, 0. That means, that 3 means 1st string, 3rd fret. The 0 means 2nd string open, the 0 means 3rd string open, and the 3 means 4th string open. Okay, so when you go to the guitar, 3 means 1st string, 3rd fret, and then open, open, open. So you just strum those 4 strings with the ring finger if you're on the 3rd fret. And that's what they're telling you to do. Okay, now you look at another part of the tabs, and you've got, and this is, now we're looking at tabs again, not the guitar, and it shows from the top down, the third string down, has a 2 on it. Okay, so that's telling you, now we're looking at a guitar, go to the 2nd fret to the 3rd string, and you're going to play 2nd fret, 3rd string. You're going to pick that note. Okay, now I'm not on the 2nd fret, but assuming that we were, that's what it's telling you to do. Then you've got 3rd string again, which would be, looking at the tabs, would be, it's going to show a 2. Okay, tabs are showing strings 1, 2, 3. It's going to show a 2 right there. Okay, that means it's going to show a 0 right there, sorry. That means you're going to play the 3rd string open. So, counting from the bottom, now you're looking at the guitar. 1, 2, 3. You're going to play that string open twice. Okay? And you'll see what I mean when I start doing the lesson, which we're going to do right now. Okay, so let's go back up here. The intro to the tabs, and I'm going to post the tabs, so don't worry, shows that I need to play 3rd fret, 1st string, and I'm going to play it with the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th string open. So I'm going to strum strings 4 through 1 8 times, and then I'm going to repeat that. Okay, the tabs show that I'm going to go on the 2nd fret, and I'm going to put my middle finger on the 3rd string and pick that once. Then it shows I'm going to pick the 3rd string open twice. Okay, then I'm going to take my ring finger again and put it on the 3rd fret, 1st string, and pick strings, strum strings 4, 3, 2, 1, twice. So you've got and that was for our G chord, just like if we were playing the song. Now it's definitely not going to be playing a G chord, but that part that I just did was for the G chord. This part is going to be for the B7. Okay, so I'm going to take my index finger, 1st fret, 4th string, middle finger, 2nd fret, 5th string, and ring finger, 2nd fret, 3rd string, and I'm going to strum strings 5, 4, 3 once. Okay, then I'm going to play an open 2nd string. I'm going to take my middle finger and put it on the 2nd string, 2nd fret. Okay, and pick it once. Then I'm going to go over with my ring finger on the 4th fret, 2nd string, and pick it once. I'm going to do the 1st string open once, middle finger 1st string 2nd fret once, take my ring finger to the 3rd fret 1st string and pick it once. Okay, so now you've got, from that beginning part, that was for our G and B7. So for the B7, it's okay. For the E minor, we're going to go 2nd fret, 1st string, middle finger, and we're going to do strings 3, 2, 1. We're going to do the 1st string open. Okay, we're going to take our middle finger, put it on the 4th string, 2nd fret, and do strings 4, 3, 2, 1. And then we're going to lift the middle finger and do the 4th string open. So that one you've got. Okay, so for that part of the song, again, from the beginning. Or where they're saying yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Okay, so for the next part of it, We've got C, B, 7, and G, and that's now it looks as though they're here to stay. For the C chord, you want to actually do a C chord, and you're going to pick the fifth string one time. Then you're going to strum strings 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, then you're going to do an open first string. You're going to go 3rd fret 2nd string once with the ring finger. Index finger 2nd string 1st fret once. And then open 2nd string. And then middle finger on the 2nd fret 3rd string once. Okay, so that would be. Okay, then you're going to take your index finger and put it on the 2nd string 1st fret and strum strings 4, 3, 2. Okay, 2nd string open, and then strings 4, 3, 2 open. Then you're going to take your middle finger on the 2nd fret 3rd string and pick it once. Okay, so from that part you've got. Okay, from the C chord you've got. And I hit one extra note in there, so ignore that one extra note. Okay, that was four. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. And now, oh, I believe in yesterday, that's going to be E minor, A7, C, and G. And sometimes in a measure you'll see the E minor and the A7. That means that the two chords are played in that one measure. Okay, so now we're on the 2nd fret, 4th string, with the middle finger. And we're just going to do strings 4 and 3. Okay, 4, 3. We're going to do the 2nd string open. Okay, we're going to take our middle finger on the 2nd fret 3rd string, I mean 4th string, and ring finger 2nd fret 3rd string, like that, and you're going to do strings 5, 4, 3. Okay, then you're going to leave your fingers there and pick the 4th string once. So that would be like this. If I can do this. Then back to your C chord, and you're going to do strings 5, 4, 3. And you're going to lift the index finger and pick the 2nd string open. So you can do it just like that. Okay, so let's just do that again. Do the C chord without the index finger. That'd be easier. And do strings 5, 4, 3. Then do the 2nd string open. Okay, do your G chord. And you don't need the bottom string. It doesn't matter because you're only going to strum strings 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. So from that E minor. The C. Okay, and that was Oh, I Believe in Yesterday. Okay, first two pretty much, and I can go longer on the video according to YouTube now. So verse two is going to be the same thing we just did. So I'm not going to go over that for you. You're going to play it exactly the same way as verse one. Okay, now. I mean, in that way I can shorten the video up. So, everything is the same on verse 2, but now we're going to go over the bridge, which is Why She Had to Go. That's going to be our B7, E minor, B7, and G twice. So for the B7 this time, it's a little bit different. You're going to go middle finger, 2nd fret, 4th string, ring finger, 2nd fret, 3rd string, and you're going to do strings 4, 3, 2 once. Okay, then you're going to slide the middle finger over to the 1st fret, 4th string, and leave your ring finger where it is. And do strings 4, 3, 2. Okay, then you're going to take your ring finger off, take your middle finger, leave it on the 2nd fret, 4th string. So middle finger, 2nd fret, 4th string, and use strings 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, then you're going to do 2nd fret, 1st string, middle finger, pick it once. 3rd fret, 1st string, ring finger, pick it once. Back to the 2nd fret, middle finger, 1st string, pick it once. And then 1st string open. So that would be... Okay, that was for the B7 and E minor. Now we're on the D7, and you want to take your index finger, 1st fret, 2nd string. You want to take your middle finger, 2nd fret, 3rd string, just like a D7. And ring finger, 2nd fret, 1st string. And you're going to do strings 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, take your hand off, do an open 1st string. Okay, 2nd string, 3rd fret, ring finger, once. And then an open 1st string again. So that's... for the D7. Now for the G chord, you're going to do strings 4, 3, 2, open, one time, and then put your ring finger on the 1st string, 3rd fret, and strum strings 4, 3, 2, 1, four times. So basically that part, that whole part is... she had to go, I don't know, it's going to be the same thing as we did before, which is 2nd fret, 4th string, middle finger, 2nd fret, 3rd string, ring finger, strings 4, 3, 2, leave your ring finger where it is, slide the middle finger over 1st fret, 4th string, go 4, 3, 2, take your ring finger off, slide your middle finger over, now you're on the 2nd fret, 4th string, and you're going to go 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, you're going to do middle finger, 1st string, 2nd fret. Okay, then you're going to go ring finger, 3rd fret, 1st string once. Back to the 2nd fret with the middle finger, 1st string, and then open. Going to do your D7 I showed you, and strum strings 4, 3, 2, 1. Take your hand off, do an open 1st string, go to the 3rd fret, 2nd string with your ring finger, and then go to the 2nd fret, 1st string, middle finger. And the G does change it a little bit here. The G chord you're going to do, you're going to go ring finger, 3rd fret, 1st string, and do strings 3, 2, 1. Okay, then you're going to take your ring finger, put it, move it up one string, so 2nd string, 3rd fret, pick it once. Index finger, 2nd string, 1st fret once. And then 2nd string open once. So from that B7, then you go back into the verse, and the verse is going to be the same, okay? So now we're going to do the end of the song, which is a coda. Remember, the coda actually ends the last G. So let's say we're at the verse, and we just did the last C and G, which is, remember, no index finger on the C, and you do strings 5, 4, 3, then you do the open 2nd string, then you do the G chord without the bottom, and you do strings 6 through 2, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and that's where he does it again, and he starts singing, etc. go to the A7 now, and basically all it is going to be open 3rd string, open 2nd string, okay, take your middle finger again on the 4th string 2nd fret, take your ring finger on the 3rd string 2nd fret, and strum strings 5, 4, 3. Pick the 4th string, leave your fingers there, pick the 4th string once. Okay, do a C chord again without the index finger and do strings 5, 4, 3 to the open 2nd string. Do the G chord with no ring finger, no bottom string, and do strings 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, so let's go through it kind of one more time, bit by bit. Intro, and I'm going to post the annotations. And you do it again. Verse 1. Okay, to the B7. Down to our C chord, this time using the index finger. That was C, D7, and G. Okay, now the E minor. Okay, let's do that again. C chord, this time no index finger. G chord. Okay, that's where they sang "Oh, I Believe in Yesterday." Now we're on the 2nd verse. Where am I at? Sorry about that. C chord with the index finger. There's our C, D7, G chord now. A, E minor. Okay, to our bridge. Second half of the bridge. To the last verse. Sorry. Do the C with the index finger. To the G chord. To our E minor. To our C with no index finger, to our G with no bottom string, to the coda, which again is just really the A7, to the C and G with no index finger, G no bottom finger. Okay, that's pretty much it. If you can read tabs, you can probably figure out how to play this. It was very hard for me to try to explain it, sorry about that, but hopefully posting the annotations will help, and hopefully they let me post this lesson. All right, everybody, take care, thanks.